What is up, all you try-hard gamers? Coming back at you with another Elite Dangerous video build. Now, I haven't made a video in a while, and that's partially due to the fact that I've been experimenting with a bunch of different builds. I originally went for the Imperial Courier, and it didn't work out as well as intended. But I applied the same principle that I wanted to use for that build for this build. And the ship that I'm using is the Crate Mark II. This is a badass ship, for those of you who don't know. Some people like it, some people don't. I like it specifically because of its speed. So we're going to get into some combat so that you guys can see what this build is capable of.
I went to
All right, so let's talk about this build. So last time I did an all ballistics build, and I was thinking to myself, well, I wonder how well an all laser build would fare, right? It sounds boring, but it's really not. And we'll get into like the in-depth aspect of it. And as you saw there, I think there was more going on there than probably what you saw. Number one, above and beyond, the name of the game with this build is speed. Okay. As fast as you can get your ship. Now, right now, as you see at the bottom left, my boost speed's at 477, which is okay, right? It's a little above normal. My top speed is 347, which is pretty decent too. Now, I don't have this fully engineered yet, but it's proof of concept, okay? Now, there are a couple ways that I got it that way. Number one, obviously, is A rating your power plant. But the big thing you want to do is you want to A rate your 6A thrusters, and you want to modify them with dirty drive tuning. And I don't even have drag drives on this thing, right? You want to put drag drives on them as well. And the reason why that you want the speed is because this ship is not about pure firepower. It's about precision firepower. It's not to say that you can't go toe-to-toe with ships out there. You can. But with this ship, it's not designed to do that. It's designed to snipe power plants, okay? Now, the way that it snipes power plants, I'll go ahead and show you my hard points. They're all pulse lasers. How boring, right? You would say, how boring is that? Well, yes, it would be boring, if not for their modifications. Now, I was looking at the engineering, I was going back and forth in engineering this, and I actually found this out on the Imperial Courier. When I went out to, I think it's Muang, or Mung, however you pronounce that shit. when I went out there and looked at the engineering options for the lasers, I noticed that there was a modification on there called Focused Weapon. Yeah, I don't think it's going to give you a description here. I'll just tell you exactly what it does. If you look over here, it still does a thermal load, right? Because it's a laser. But look at this. Armor piercing. 52. 94. 80% armor piercing. So this effectively gives you the best of both worlds. You're using your lasers, but your lasers, once they take down the shields, which is their job, they pierce armor. How amazing is that? So this focused weapon modification increases the maximum range by like 5,000, but up to 5,040 in my current with my current level of modification, which is only to 3. And damage falloff start at 840. So not only, this is ultimately a sniper rifle build. Now, some people would say, well, Mr. Tryhard Gamer, if you want to snipe power plants, why would you not just use the rail guns? Well, there are a few reasons for that. I tried it. Number one, rail guns are really hard to hit. Okay, really hard to hit. If you're like a savant at the game, You can use them, okay? I'm sure you're good at them. Good for you. But we're try-hard gamers here, right? Not all of us are amazing. Number two, they have ammo to them, okay? And number three, you would be able to, in theory, synthesis ammo, which would get rid of the last con that I just mentioned. But here's the problem. For the basic ammo type, it requires vanadium or vanadium, however you pronounce that, and that's like an uncommon to rare material source. So you're going to spend all this time on planets farming the crap out of vanadium just to get the ammo to do a long campaign for a build like this, right? Not only that, you're spending so much time at trying to aim properly. And I don't know if you guys noticed, but in the combat footage you just saw, I'm flying with flight assist off now. I learned how to fly with fly assist off. So if you're having to aim your shots with pinpoint accuracy and you're flying with flying assist off, it's going to be a bad time for you unless you're a savant. And not all of us are savants at this game, right? So that's it for the pulse lasers. I just fitted them all out with that, all the same modifications. No, actually, there's one more thing. And I'm going to try this on all of my lasers. Not gotten a chance to do this. I believe on my mediums, rather, I had this modification. Emissive munitions. This is important. And the description of it is a little deceptive because it doesn't tell you exactly what it does. It says experimental upgrade that causes strikes to envelop the target in energetic particles, significantly amplifying its signature at the cost of increasing heat generation for the attacker. Well, that sort of sounds like what? It makes its radar range further or less farther or something like that? No, that's not what it does. What it actually does is it makes your beams more accurate. Okay, now remember, we want pinpoint accuracy. The idea is not to overwhelm the opponent with a shit ton of damage. It's to get close enough to be able to snipe out their hard points, whether that be their drive, whether that be their power plant, whatever it is. And for those of you who don't know, when you snipe out a power plant, there's a good chance that their ship's just going to blow up regardless of their hull. So, in theory, if they still had 90% hull, 80% hull, and you snipe out their power plant, their ship goes kaput, and you get the kill. Okay, that's the basic idea of this build. I mentioned speed before. Another thing as far as speed is concerned here, you want to get lightweight on the lightweight modifications on not everything but a lot of your things, your modules, and you also want to reduce the mass as much as possible. This is going to make your ship more maneuverable, and I believe it increases the top speed as well as boost speed. But if you had to have a priority as far as speed is concerned, number one, again, 7A or 6A thrusters, as we said before, with drag drives as an experimental, and the modification that we're using for that, let me look again, is not power plant. Dirty drive tuning, sorry. Dirty drive tuning is what you want. So, other than that, there is one more aspect of this build that I want to talk about, which may seem odd to you guys, but a lot of people, I think, build their crates to tank from a shield, from the shield aspect. Like, they want to put a bunch of boosters, shield boosters, on their ship. There's one problem with that. With every shield booster you put on your ship, it significantly reduces the top speed and the boost speed. Now, you're going to become more shield tanky, right? But you're going to lose a lot of speed for that. So what I opted to do was to make this hull tanky, okay? And the way that I did that was by putting reactive surface composite and also putting... Do I have three... One, two, three. Three hull reinforcement packages on there, which is going to boost your integrity. Now, the integrity that I have right now, which is 1477, it's pretty good. A little above average, right? Like I said, I don't have this completely modded out yet or engineered out. But as you saw, I was tanking some shots from that Anaconda, right? And even blew up the Anaconda with this build. So, it's definitely doable. This build, like, at the end of it, when everything is completely engineered, if you know how to fly it, which is another aspect of this build, if you know how to fly your ship, can be devastating. And I've tested this out in conflict zones as well. In conflict zones, I was just as successful. Even more so in conflict zones, and I'll tell you why. There's a major difference between one-on-one, your ship against another ship, and the ship that you're trying to attack being distracted by another ship. Okay, and the difference is this. When you fire on the opponent's ship, it's going to automatically hone on you, right? Well, what it's going to do is the NPC likes to point their nose directly at you so that they can get a shot at you. You'll know that, notice this in almost every NPC fight. No matter where you're at, they will try to point their nose down at you to get their damage in. That's bad for a couple reasons. One, obviously you're taking damage. But two, it reduces the line of sight of your weapons to be able to snipe their power plants, right? So what you have to do is to be able to maneuver in a way. Typically, the best way to do it is with flight assist completely off. I'll be honest with you. But to maneuver in a way that you can get a line of sight on the top or the bottom, preferably the bottom of their ship, to get to that power plant. You want to blow that power plant up. Now, second scenario, if it's distracted by another ship and another ship is firing on it, that's easy peasy for you with this build. Easy peasy for you. And the reason why that is that obviously you can get any sort of angle that you want on that ship. It's this build is all about flying, being able to fly efficiently, and being able to come at your attack from specific angles. That's the number one thing. Now, one last thing, and I won't bore you guys. I'll try not to bore you guys. I cannot overstate this enough. When I first started this game, I was using flight assist off every once in a while, right? But I decided to try to fly with flight assist completely off and only use it on in specific situations. Sort of a reverse of what I was doing before, and it is night and day. And if you use flight assist off with this build, you will be able to demolish just about everything out there, provided that it's not like 60 Corvettes, right? Obviously, I don't think any ship could outdo that. One of the main parts of this build, also, that you do not want to forget, and you saw me do it in that video, I think a couple times, are your repair limpet controllers. Now, these things are a godsend. Given that we are a little tanky and are pushing more of the damage to our hull rather than putting a shit ton of shield boosters on, we want to have repair limpet controllers for those long campaigns. Now, for those of you who don't know, the way that these work is that you have to have a cargo rack with limpets on it. And you fill them up with your limpets. And when you need to repair your hull, you fire off a repair limpet controller and it repairs your hull, basically. It's a godsend. It's amazing. And it will keep you from having to go from dock to dock in case you get low, right? We're not sporting like a 10,000 integrity ship right here. This is a medium ship. So we're going to be taking some damage in battle, but we've got it just to the point where just about anything that we come up against, including anacondas, as you saw in that video, we can take on. We'll take some damage for it, but we'll repair that back with these limpet controllers. The other stuff that I have on here is just like I said before, the hull reinforcement packages, advanced docking computer, fuel scoop, pretty basic stuff, 6A shield generator. And another thing too is we'll go to remote workshop so you could see, I think I showed you the engines. I've got the 3 armor. lightweight. You want the lightweight instead of the heavy duty, and the reason why is to get your mass down so that it will increase your speed and maneuverability. You absolutely want that. Now, it does reduce hull boost, but increases your kinetic, thermal, and explosive resistances. Power plant. See, this is the thing about this build. This build is not power heavy either. So you don't have to worry too much about that. I've got like a an overcharged power plant 2 right there, and you saw in the outfitting screen, I'm nowhere near the limit with this build as far as power is concerned. Pulse lasers, I've got them pretty much all to 3. It's not even fully kitted out, and we were taking down Anacondas in that hazardous zone pretty much no problem. So, yeah, that's basically it. So, please like and subscribe. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will catch you back on the next video.